tangible, objective sightings. Now, the objects, by the way, that were doing things, it was just utterly incredibly extraordinary.
That we can relate to any conceivable threat to the United States.
UFO, visit of an alien. It is an old topic. It is interesting, but I had been skeptical of their existence. Rather than trying to scientifically examine UFO cases, a lot of horror stories had been spread, and the stories just strengthened paranormal belief, just like this video. However, some cases are different in quality. Some left video with specific circumstance, and some left physical evidence. And there are a few cases recognized by public institutions. Of course, it is hard for anyone to give a correct answer, but let me introduce some cases that enable scientific inferences. Let's go to Chile in 2014. On November 11, 2014, a Chilean Navy helicopter was patrolling the coast of Santiago. The helicopter was flying north along the west coast. The helicopter was flying at an altitude of about 4,500 feet on a clear afternoon, and the temperature at that height was 10 degrees Celsius. On board were a pilot, a Navy captain with many years of flying experience, and a technician testing an infrared camera. However, at 1:52 p.m., while filming the terrain, the engineer was able to observe a strange object flying to the left over the sea. The velocity and the altitude of the flying object appeared to be about the same as the helicopter, and it was approximately 35 to 40 miles away. The technician captured the object with an infrared camera to take a better definition image. The infrared camera clearly captured it, but it was a round-shaped object that was different from the aircraft we know. People in the helicopter immediately requested identification from two nearby radar stations. Both stations easily picked up the helicopter, but neither station could detect mysterious object on radar. The pilot tried several times to communicate with the object, but received no reply. Chilean air traffic controllers confirmed that no traffic, either civilian or military, had been reported in the area. After suspicious video had been reported, CIFA, a government agency researching unidentified flying object, started an investigation. Astronomers, Air Force photo analysis team, video analysts, and nuclear chemists were mobilized to understand the phenomenon. According to analysts, the video was not fake, and the flying object was certainly moving on its own. The flying object was a real phenomenon. The Chilean government investigated the video for 2 years before releasing it, but came to no conclusion. What exactly is the flying object? First, the biggest characteristic of the flying object in the video is that there are two hot spots ejecting a massive plume. And the object moved away from the plume at the end of the video. French analysts in this project proposed that the object was a medium-haul aircraft. The effluent trail observed on two occasions probably resulted from dumping some cabin waste water, forming a plume oriented by wind blowing from the west. According to their analysis, the distance between two hot spots was quite close to that of two jet engines of a medium-haul aircraft. However, some questions still remain. First, if it was an airplane, why didn't it respond to communications? All airplane must obtain a permit to land in Santiago or any other airport. To land, this object had to accept communication, but it did not. Where did it land if it was an airplane? Second, it was detected by an infrared camera, but not by an optical camera and radar. Infrared cameras are designed to detect the heat energy coming from an object, while an optical camera detects the visible light reflected from the object. The darker color indicates high heat, as captured by the infrared lens. The object might be covered with hot gas, and that could be a reason why it was only detected by infrared camera. Third, what is the chemical plume in the video? Airplanes do fuel dumping before landing in order to lose weight to prevent damage. So, you could think that the plume is a result of dumping fuel or wastewater. Well, this is unlikely. All airplanes releasing any substance in Chilean airspace must get permission from DGAC, Directorate General of Civil Aviation. Let's assume that this was a really sewage. And there is why it make no sense. It was 10 degrees Celsius, and given the warm air temperature, the water would immediately fall to the ocean. According to NASA, for the plume to form this upward contrail, an extremely cold environment and high altitude are necessary. This is why contrails do not form when airplanes take off and land. So, the plume ejected from the object would be some kind of gas or energy, not liquid. Lastly, it was moving too slow to be an airplane. The size of two hot spots remains almost the same throughout the video. If it was a winged aircraft, it had to be heading away, but it was moving so slow that the size of the object did not change a lot. Some people argue that this might be a new type of drone in secret. They claim it is why the object was not detected on radar. First, let's see whether a military drone can fly at this high altitude or not. A military drone can fly up to 50,000 feet. The incident happened at an altitude of 4,500 feet, so it is possible for a drone to fly at this altitude. But, one question remains. Why did new confidential military drone fly near Santiago, a city with a population of 5 million? In Chile, the Atacama Desert occupies a large part of the country, and it is one of the most unpopulated area in the world. And it is the place where the test of new military drones are usually conducted. If it was a drone, it might be tested in a desolate area like Atacama Desert. Therefore, it is not reasonable to carry out such secrets near highly populated city. It is hard to say that this is an airplane or a military drone. Then, what did we see? The UFO phenomenon occurs suddenly. Even if it was filmed, the video gives limited explanation on what happened. Based on the evidence shown in the video, we can only eliminate incorrect answers, and it is difficult for anyone to say the correct answer. However, scientific speculation on UFO is still interesting. I will introduce another UFO case in the next video. Subscription and likes are motivation to continuing this channel. Thank you for watching.